There's been another massive legal blow to Donald Trump and the Trump Organization this time, dealt by New York Supreme Court Judge Justice Arthur Engoron, who ruled that the former president and his company, yeah, they committed fraud by inflating their assets, i.e. lying about that, in order to score more business deals, more loans, etc. This again is part of Attorney General of New York Letitia James's lawsuit against the Trump Organization, and this is huge. This is it. The New York judge found Donald Trump and his adult sons liable. Again, notice Ivanka has escaped from this, liable for fraud and canceled the Trump Organization's business certificate. A shocking ruling that poses an existential threat to the former president's financial empire as he runs for a second term in the White House. Judge Arthur Engoron's ruling on Monday is a complete rejection of Trump's arguments that he didn't inflate the values of his golf courses, hotels, homes at Mar-a-Lago, and Seven Springs on financial statements. And that ruling is in response to Letitia James's $250 million lawsuit. That's what she's seeking in damages for the state of New York. A ban on the Trumps from serving as officers of a business in New York. That's okay, there's always Florida. And to stop the company from engaging in business transactions for 5 years. A trial is expected to begin next week, people, on the amount of damages owed and the full breadth of Engoron's ruling and how it will play out still remains unclear. We're obviously gonna cover that trial next week, but this is huge. This is massive to the point where Engoron has said that they will be discussing how to manage the dissolution of these corporate entities. He said this, the questions still remain as to how the receiver would dissolve those properties, if the ruling would impact properties located outside of New York State, including Mar-a-Lago, and if the Trumps could transfer the New York-based assets into a new company located out of state. He better slow his roll against DeSantis, because he's gonna need that governor and all of the powerful folks over there in Florida. It is unclear, but to give you a sense, we're gonna obviously keep reporting this next week, but to give you a sense of the severity of it, this was a question that Trump's defense attorney, Christopher Kiss, asked the judge. He said, certain of the entities own physical assets like 40 Wall Street and Trump Tower. Are those assets now going to be sold or managed under direction of the monitor? So they're not talking about did they win this lawsuit or not. They've failed. They've lost this lawsuit. The question is how much money and how are these assets going to be dissolved and which assets do they apply to? Oh my God, Farron, this is huge.
I love how the lawyer is just like, so is like, do you sell this? Like, what do we do? I don't know. Like, no, you're the lawyer. You should 100% know what is happening, even if the judge hasn't been crystal clear with you. And of course, I think what a lot of people didn't understand about this ruling on Tuesday, because a lot of people thought like, oh, okay, it's done. Like, no. All that was determined was that he's guilty. He's still going to trial. And Letitia James, by the way, is pushing to make sure the trial does not get canceled, because Trump's lawyers are already like, well, we should just not do it. But Letitia James wants to present her evidence. Mm. She wants it to be heard and she wants it to be out there for everyone to see. That is the whole big point of this. It's not just getting the additional instruction from Engoron. It's James being like, whoa, no. I got some things here that I think everybody needs to be aware of. So we're going to do this. We're going to go through the motions and y'all are going to see firsthand how bad this fraud was. And that's honestly what scares Trump the most about this. Like, he doesn't necessarily care about paying $250 million. I know he loves money. He doesn't want to lose a dollar. But the biggest blow to him with this case is the egotistical blow.
Yeah.
This is going to prove that he is not worth as much as he says he is. He's sued people in the past for saying he's not worth as much as he has claimed.
Yeah.
Like, that's how much it bothers him. So James is going to go through and make sure that everybody knows this guy is full of it And I've got the receipts to back that up.
And that can still go forward. The trial is still going forward. And I'm sorry if I misrepresented this, because it's just like my mind is, you know, discombobulated with all of these cases. But the trial can still go forward, even if the judge has already ruled that you got to like dismantle these organizations. Is that your understanding of it?
Yeah, absolutely. And the judge will have to go through and fully explain what it means, but it will also give the Trump lawyers the opportunity, even though they don't seem to know that they have the opportunity, they can argue against it. And the judge may say, okay, these entities here, these can stay, these cannot. So it's not as final as it seems on paper. There is the opportunity, although I don't think they will be successful. I think it will be the full everything has to go sale. But it's gonna be very technical once it gets down to that part. And it's gonna be a lot of things that are, you know, I don't even understand either. But the big thing is just James getting the opportunity to show the world, like, here's all the evidence.
Yes.
Look what I did. So that'll be the fun part. Then the other part's going to be ticky-tack accounting and, you know, all of that stuff.
Sure, right. And like what you can I still do cameos? I feel like Don Trump Jr. is going to want to know, is that legal? But out of New York, if I'm in Mar-a-Lago? Right, but so next week, we're going to really see that full accounting. We're going to see the breadth of fraud in terms of what they lied about, what they actually had. You know, I'm reminded of the time that Ivanka Trump, I believe, gave an interview, and I forgot which media outlet, but she said something about her dad, you know, pointing to a homeless person and saying, this guy has more money than me. Effectively saying, like, I'm in the red so bad, like we are. This is probably one of the many bankruptcies. But of course, he bounced back because, you know, rich people with famous last names do.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.